Greetings. This is the next in a long and continually growing list of reasons to reject Islam. Reason number 13. How many errors is too many? As Didet would say, "So I'm asking Muslims, how many errors do you have to find and prove in the Quran before you recognize and accept it is not from God? How many?" Of course, those who blindly defend Muhammad declare, "There are no errors in the Quran," as if the simple declaration, "there are none," makes that statement correct. And no doubt, those sincere in their desperate support of Muhammad believe they may say anything to defend Muhammad, supportable or not. So I am asking Muslims, how many defects does it take to prove the Quran is not from God? 1,000? Surely 1,000 errors would prove the Quran is false, right? What about 500 then? Would Allah make 500 mistakes? How about only 100? If Allah made 100 mistakes, would the Quran still be trustworthy? Maybe only 50 mistakes would still make it okay, right? What do you think, O Muslim? Can Allah make 50 mistakes in His Quran and you will still follow it? 50 seems too many to me. After all, Allah is claimed to be perfect. Does someone perfect make 50 mistakes? What about 10 mistakes? Is 10 proven mistakes all right to you? What about 5 mistakes? Or 4? Or 3? Or 2? Does it take 2 proven errors in the Quran? I think if you are honest, you must state that any error, even one, is too many. But what did the Quran, say on the matter? Surah 4:82. Will they not then try to understand this Quran? Had it issued from any but God, they would surely have found in it many an inner contradiction. But no, they meditate not on the recitation, and if it had been from any other than God, certainly they would have found in it many contradictions. From the Amatul Omar, why do they not ponder over the Quran? Had it been from anyone other than Allah, they would surely have found a good deal of inconsistency therein. Now it is very interesting to me, looking at the 29 generally accepted translations of this surah, not one translation renders this as errors. In every case, it renders a variation of discrepancy, inconsistency, contradictions, and inner contradictions. And that is a bit of an aha moment if you really ponder the claim of the Quran. Consistency is a very different thing than correctness. Surah 4:82 does not claim the Quran is perfect and correct. It claims the tales in the Quran, the message, is consistent. The stories Muhammad told in one surah must be the same as when retold in another surah. And those are very clever weasel words indeed. But in what other surah does the Quran make claims about errors or consistency? Surah 10:37. This Quran is not such as could have been produced by anyone but God. It fulfills that, the predictions, which came before it and gives a fuller explanation of the earlier revelations. This is fascinating indeed. The Quran claims it fulfills predictions. And it begs some questions. What predictions? When? By whom? The predictions which came before it and gives a fuller explanation of the revelations. Gives a fuller explanation? Really? Huge brass balls to make that claim when there is nothing new in the Quran. Name 10 things the Quran explains clearly in detail that the previous scriptures spoke about. Go ahead, I challenge every Mohammedan on earth to name 10 such teachings. Surah 15:9. Surely we have revealed the reminder, and we will most assuredly be its guardian. Reminder? You cannot remind someone of things they have never heard before. And we will most surely safeguard it? I always flinch at Muhammad claiming to say Allah said something. The lies of it all are viscerally offensive. There really are no other clear and unambiguous claims of the Quran being error-free. None that I could find using search software. None that say in clear words, there are no errors in the Quran. Which still gets back to my original question. How many errors must be proven in the Quran, O Muslim, before you examine it with honest eyes? I personally know of 3 completely provable errors. And that is 3 too many for a perfect Allah to make. What happened to Pharaoh when he chased the children of Israel from Egypt? I'm sure the God of Abraham who saved the children of Israel would know. Do you agree, O Muslim? Would the God of all know what happened to Pharaoh? Let's see what Allah, or Muhammad, said in the Quran. Surah 28:37. And Moses replied, "My Lord knows best who comes with guidance from him, and who will attain the heavenly abode in the hereafter. The wrongdoers shall never prosper." Verse 38. Pharaoh said, "O nobles, I know of no God for you other than myself." So he's claiming he's God. "So Haman, burn me bricks of clay and build me a high tower that I may have a look at the God of Moses, though I consider him to be one of the liars." So Muhammad recounts that Pharaoh calls Moses a liar. Verse 39. "He and his hosts behaved arrogantly in the land without any justification, thinking that they would not be recalled to us." Recalled to us, meaning killed, dead, and brought before Allah for judgment. Verse 40. "So we seized him and his hosts and cast them into the sea. Consider the fate of the wrongdoers." Allah counts Pharaoh among the wrongdoers. Verse 41. "We had made them leaders, but they called people to the fire, and on the day of judgment they will not be helped." So Pharaoh and his leaders became the first at the head of the line, calling people to the fire. Verse 42. "We have caused a curse to follow them in this world, and on the day of judgment they will be among the wretched." Wow, a curse to follow them in this world, and they will be among the wretched on the day of judgment. The clear Quran sure has some harsh things to say about Pharaoh's fate. And there is even more. 17:102. He said, "You know full well that none has sent down these signs but the Lord of the heavens and the earth as eye-opening evidence. Indeed, Pharaoh, I can see that you are doomed." This is supposed to be Moses talking to Pharaoh. So he, Pharaoh, resolved to scare them out of the land, meaning the Jews. "But we drowned him," meaning Pharaoh, "along with all those who were with him." Clearly, the clear Quran says that Allah drowned Pharaoh. Wouldn't you agree? The clear Quran is so very clear on the subject. Allah drowned Pharaoh. Surah 43, verse 51. Pharaoh called to his people, "My people, is the kingdom of Egypt not mine? And these rivers that flow at my feet, are they not mine? Do you not see? Am I not better than this contemptible man who can hardly make his meaning clear?" Pharaoh is talking badly of Moses here. Pharaoh was not a good man, was he? Verse 53. "And why have not armlets of gold been bestowed on him? And why is there not a train of angels accompanying him?" In this way he fooled his people, and they obeyed him. They were a rebellious people. You've got to love this pronoun confusion in the clear Quran. Did Moses fool his people? So is this Pharaoh talking about Moses fooling his people? Or is it Pharaoh fooling his people? And this is Muhammad talking about Pharaoh fooling his people? You have to read several translations to find comments and insertions saying this particular he is Pharaoh. "Then when they provoked our wrath, we took revenge on them and drowned every one of them." I'm willing to go out on a limb here and say this is Allah speaking. Provoked our wrath is kind of a giveaway. And what exactly does Allah say he did to Pharaoh? We took revenge on them and drowned every one of them. Allah says he drowned every one of them. Now maybe there is some secret Arabic meaning of drowning. If you speak or read Arabic, look at this for me. Let me know. Does drowned actually mean dead? Or did Allah simply make it appear to be so? Perhaps Allah neither drowned them nor even wet them down with a rainstorm. It wouldn't be the first time Allah deceived all who were watching an event. But the clear Quran is just so, well, clear on the issue. Surah 28, 37 through 41, Pharaoh drowned. Surah 17, 102 through 103, Pharaoh drowned. Surah 43, 55, Pharaoh drowned. Boy, I'm glad there are no contradictions in the Quran. And the next reference to Pharaoh I found was Surah 10, 87 through 93. I don't really think I should bore you with those details. After all, there are no contradictions in the Quran. But let's just make sure. It's only one more passage to look up. And Allah's not afraid of us actually reading His Quran, after all. It is a clear book, a clear guidance with no contradictions. If it wasn't from Allah, you would find contradictions in it. And that's like saying, if you find contradictions, it's not from God, right? Well, I was probably mistaken there being errors. After all, in three surahs, the Quran clearly says Pharaoh drowned. 10:88, Moses prayed, Our Lord, you have bestowed upon Pharaoh and his nobles pomp and wealth in the present life, whereby they lead people astray from your path. Our Lord, destroy their riches and harden their hearts so that they shall not believe until they are faced with grievous punishment. Even in his curse, Moses is most beneficent and oft forgiving. Only harden them, Allah, until they are faced with grievous punishment. And God, or Allah, said, Your prayers are answered. So stay on the right course and do not follow the path of those who do not know. So we brought the children of Israel across the sea. Pharaoh and his troops pursued them arrogantly and aggressively. When he was about to drown, Pharaoh exclaimed, I believe that there is no deity save him in whom the children of Israel believe, and I am of those who surrender themselves to him. Wait a minute. Pharaoh made a deathbed shahada? Only now, when you had always been a rebel and a wrongdoer? So we shall save your body this day, so that you may serve as a sign for those who come after you. For many people are indeed heedless of our signs. What the? We shall save your body this day as a sign for people who ignore signs. For many people are indeed heedless of our signs. That makes no sense. And we shall save your body this day. Allah saved Pharaoh. Pharaoh did not drown. Look at it again. So we shall save your body this day, so that you may serve as a sign for those who come after you. That's a clear contradiction, my friend. The Quran says that Pharaoh was drowned. The Quran says that Pharaoh was saved. We saw his shahada. This is a contradiction. Both cannot be true. So I am asking Muslims, how can you explain Allah's mistake? How can Allah forget he drowned Pharaoh? But let's take a look at one more aspect of this failure. When did Muhammad make his error? Clearly, Muhammad said three times Pharaoh was drowned, and one time claimed Pharaoh was saved. Well, when did Allah get it wrong? Was it right, then wrong? Or was it wrong, and then Allah got it right? Or was it some other confused sequence? The four surah to examine are Surah 10, Surah 17, Surah 28, and Surah 43. According to Islamic sites, the order in which they were revealed is, and I am getting this from missionislam.com. If you have issue with the order, shoot them. Surah 28, was number 49 revealed, and it was in Mecca. Surah 17 was number 50 revealed, and it too was in Mecca. Surah 10 was number 51 in Revelation order, and it too came in Mecca. So all three of them back to back to back. Surah 43 was number 63, but it was also in Mecca. I find that fascinating. All these surahs were Meccan surahs, all during his early storytelling days. I had thought perhaps Mo had three consistent at Mecca, then got it wrong many years later at Medina. But to me, this scenario is a worse scenario. It means Muhammad got it wrong even before leaving Mecca. So I am asking Muslims, how many errors does it take? If the author of the Quran claims contradictions are proof against the Quran, you must consider this contradiction about Pharaoh's fate as evidence against the Quran. And that is why this is reason number 13 to reject the Quran. Reason number 13 to reject Islam. If you call yourself Muslim, do you have any respect for God? Do you have any regard for logic? Do you have any desire for the truth? The author of the Quran issued a challenge to you. He gave you a test to apply against the Quran, and the Quran fails the very test the Quran suggests. Unless you think some errors are okay. After all, the author does say many. He does not say there are no contradictions. Read it carefully. He does not say there are no contradictions. Will they not then try to understand the Quran? Had it issued from any but God, they would surely have found in it many an inner contradiction. Evidently, the author allows for himself to make a few errors and contradictions. They would surely have found in it many an inner contradiction. So Muhammad hides Allah's allowable errors somewhere between many and none. Maybe one mistake in the Quran is okay. And if one, then five are okay. And if five, then 50 are okay. And if 50, then 500 errors are okay. After all, how many is many? But I think that is wrong. Provable errors discredit the Quran. And that is why this is reason number 13 to reject Islam. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.